right now. I hope you're doing well, preferably splendastic. Welcome to, I guess, what we are going to call the Outside the Lines Community Spotlight Project, where, as you can see by the quickly moving slideshow, not only did I create back in the end of April, beginning of May 2022, a little play on words where I colored the actual Outside the Lines words using colored pencils. And then the next day I thought, you know, why not put it out there, you know, on a whim to see if anyone else wants to, you know, take a stab at doing something creative with the Outside the Lines, you know, whether they want to print it out and destroy it or do something traditional, experimental, whatever. And as you can see, or as you've seen, I was only expecting about, you know, maybe 20, something like that, submissions, but I have received over 100. So not only am I going to have to try to keep this video to about an hour or less if I can, but I really hope that you will try to watch as much as you can. And the reason that is, I ask that, is because you'll never see the same creation or work twice. Everyone, this is the really cool part, the unexpected part about this. Well, I kind of half expected this, that everyone had their own unique take on, you know, what they wanted to do with the Outside the Lines image. And, you know, they are free to do it, you know, whatever they want, no matter how talented. This isn't a competition, no judging, you know, just whoever wants to participate, and I'll include it in the video. So I'm only going to be able to spend about 30 seconds on going over everyone's image. Again, I was only hoping to get, you know, maybe a couple dozen or so, and then spend more time. But due to the large number of submissions, I have to get through them fairly quickly. Otherwise, we'll be here for like 3 hours. And the last thing I want to say just before we get started here is this is going to be the first in an ongoing periodic little series where every 3 or 4 months, like maybe twice a year, I reach out to anyone in the community, you know, again, viewer or subscriber or not, to participate in something. The next thing I'd like to do come the fall, you know, August, September, is something involving photography, something a little more accessible, in case someone, you know, is not good at editing images or drawing. I think most folks have a camera, whether a real camera or a phone, and I'm not exactly sure what that project will consist of. You know, a scavenger hunt or taking a picture of something green. You know, I don't know, we'll see. All right, so without any further ado, why don't we get started? I'm going to be going through all of these images first, and then there's about six, about nine videos, and I'll be going, I'll be showing those towards the end. So this will be alphabetical by the person's first name or alias. Okay, so let's get started. First up, we have an image creation that is a Kirby theme by someone that went by a good username. And I'm not too familiar with Kirby. I think it's a video game. I think Kirby had its own video game or whatever. So I know a little bit about it, but not too much. So I'm assuming these are all characters here of Kirby. And again, like I said, this wasn't a competition about how well see, and like I said, you'll see, it's great, all the different takes that people had, their own little vision. So there we go. Kirby down here in the bottom right on a star, I guess. I don't know who this is over on the right, or this King Penguin, big Kirby face for the O. So, yeah, that's great. So, thank you, a good username. Next, we have something by Abby Harath, who also goes by that name on Twitch. This is we have Outside the Lines with some drop shadow added to it. And then we have it over a background where it looks like Abby took the time to create all of these little circles. It just must have taken forever. Now, I mean, I don't know either. I'm just having some fun, Abby. It might just be a simple little backdrop, and that's just fine. Again, it's not about how little or how much effort. But hey, this is, you know, perfect, simple, right to the point, nice little image there with that, like, you might see in a photograph, the bokeh blurred, a little specular lighting effects, I guess you would say. So thank you, Abby. Next we have submission by Adam Merlin, aka Tree Man, patient ID 7R33, who says they used to sell baby trees before the NWO takeover. They now reside in Arkham Sanitarium, drawing pixel art and playing games. Adam is half tree, half human. So we can see they drew a little pixel Corvus up here, maybe a portal, a rift. We have Dave right there, maybe another portal or a rift. Rubber Chicken, of course, and Professor Clemens, maybe, on a good day. Oh, up close. Okay, so that must be from that video. And I didn't ask anyone to, you know, do anything in particular. I just said, have at it, and that's what they did. They had at it. Monster Hands, maybe. And then the little quest giver quest down here, I guess, with the little red upside down exclamation point mark as well. So thank you, Adam. And again, I gotta get through these as quick as possible. The next submission we have is by another Adam. I don't think it's the same Adam. It might be, but no big deal. This particular Adam says they are an aspiring pixel artist, and they placed some Easter eggs inside a few of the letters. I'm not sure if you're familiar with what pixel art is. It's basically art by just using pixels, creating designs, people, environments, buildings. There's a lot of cool pixel art out there. So I had a hard time trying to figure out what was inside, so I asked Adam to clarify, and the next image will show exactly. So in the D and the E, we have a profile of Corvus. And if you're new here to my channel, these images of these characters are the characters that I portray on my channel. Down here in the I and the N, we have the beatnik, Margaret. In the D and the H, you can see her mouth there. All right, so there's Margaret. And then Dave. Cthulhu, sorry, Kevin, up here in the O. So very cool. Thank you, Adam. Moving on next, we have Amadav, who created an Outside the Lines. Looks like it's kind of falling apart here. I'm not exactly sure. Let's see. Amadav says, for each letter, they used a significant color that starts with the same letter as follows. Olive, ultramarine, teal, silver, indigo, dandelion, emerald, heliotrope, lilac, and Navajo. And there we go. So it looks like, okay, I see what's going on here. So this little below the E, that's actually the part of the E up top, but it's falling. It's almost as if the strings are attached and they're all kind of falling apart. And a nice variety of colors. So thank you, Amadav. Next, we have submission lines here with a lot of splatter, ink splatter, you could say. We have a pink something going on over here. Very different and strange. Some shadow, a little bit, or just larger ink spots in the back, and then a bell. So I'm not really sure if this is just random or if there is any significance to the bell and the pink, whatever thing is going on over here. But anyway, just another cool interpretation. So thank you, Akio or Akio. Next, we have a submission by Alex, who took a lot of time and effort, as which everybody did, you know, took time and effort to, you know, download and print out and copy paste and do all kinds of stuff to do their creation and save it and then send it to me. So thank you, everyone, for all the work that you put in. So yeah, Alex took a lot of screenshots or thumbnails from different videos of mine and put the outside, the lines, obviously, inside each little picture, Tinfoil Hat Society. Yeah, so all the different videos that I've done. So yeah, just another fun little take. So thank you, Alex, for your little homage there, I guess. All right, next we have a submission by AlexDS13, who says they love art. Unfortunately, they've never been satisfied with their hand drawing capabilities, but at a young age got into coloring in graph paper, and 20 years later or so, they still love it, and it led them to a career, a job. And they wanted to say, hey kids, you know, pursue your passions and develop your hobbies. You may not end up where you expect, but hopefully you'll end up doing something great. And so, yeah, just like me here on YouTube, I never expected to do this. So anyway, so you can see what they've done here, a lot of detail. Well, here's a little sample of their process. They take a plain grid there, I guess put outside the lines over it, and then start to color it, I guess, take a color and just, you know, draw over that way, something like that, I would assume or imagine. And then we have the final little image there, so very cool, and I like it, so, and very different. Don't think I've ever seen anything like that similar to pixel art, so thank you, Alexis. Sorry, did I say Alex? Alexis. Next person we have submission is by Ambrosia, who drew their own outside the lines, which is just fine. And then this little character reminds me of Enderman, the Enderman from Minecraft. I'm not sure if that's who it's supposed to be. Some people did give a little explanation to their drawing, but it wasn't necessary. Yeah, very cool, very kind of painting kind of thing. Sketch, and maybe this person down here drew all of this. They have a little pencil in their hand. Maybe this is Ambrosia. You know, they are from another dimension. So thank you, Ambrosia, for your submission. And next we have a submission by Andy, aka Stylix. I thought they sent in two images, and I don't know where the other one is. I thought I saved it. I'm not sure, but they created this little space scene with outside the lines drawn in themselves, a little bit of a blur kind of effect, and a comet passing through. So very cool. Thank you, Andy. Andy also says they recently started practicing graphic design, particularly vector graphics. So best of luck, Andy. Okay, moving on. Next, we have submission by someone who wishes to remain anonymous. So we have, I don't know, I can't explain, there's some kind of explosion going on in the background, and then within the letters of outside the lines, we have a woman's hand, or person's hand, with a rose tattoo, and they are also holding a rose. You can see the stem of the rose, a little bit of the green petals down here, fingernails red, and there's the rose petal right in the back there. And then we have this strange kind of looks to me a little retro retro video, kind of like with the outside the lines of the extra letters, the effect there. So thank you, Anonymous. Next we have by Barack Obama, not the Barack, of course, someone that changed the master of puppets. This is, in case you're not familiar, an album cover by Metallica. So that's not original, but they changed the master of puppets, which is the title of the album, to Outside the Lines. So that's very cool. One of my favorite albums. Oh no, I'm sorry. The Metallica logo would be up here, and then at the bottom it would have said Master of Puppets. So there we go. All right, so thank you, Barack. Next we have Beck, who says they are from Wales and they weren't sure what to draw and thought the letters looked cold, so I gave them all hats. The flag on the left is the Welsh flag. I included it because it has a dragon on it and is very cool. So there we go, all the letters, nice little hats, a witch's hat, a king or queen, both a king and a queen's hat, birthday hat, Viking, etc., etc., Santa Claus hat, pirate, yeah, another top hat there, and maybe a chef's hat there. So very cool, and like I said, you see, it's just very cool. That's what I love about this, is how everybody has their own take and their own little, you know, vision for what they wanted to do. So thank you, Beck. Next, we have a submission by B. This is the, there's two B's that will be in this video. I think so. The first B and the other B will submit in a video. We'll get to at the very end. We have a Margaret themed, like B drew Margaret with the original Margaret mask and everything, some hearts, and then we have a rainbow kind of color thing up here, as well as you know, the different colors and shades and all that. So very cool, and you know, I'm just a dedicated to Margaret, a big fan of Margaret, I would suppose. And there we go. So thank you, B, for your submission. Next submission is called Belligerent Birds by Vidar Erickson. And I don't think, I'm just checking to see if I had any notes about this. Don't think so. But you can see a lot of different types of birds that are like spies and Rambo, and a lot of them with guns. So kind of like a spy kind of a thing going on here. There's another one down here with a shotgun, a top hat one there in disguise. We have like a chef. There's like some keys on a key ring there, maybe. I'm not really sure. Or tools. And another one in a black and white kind of sweater with a drink and something to eat. So very cool, very different. Little bow tie and a little scarf there in the pocket. Not scarf, handkerchief. So very cool. Thank you, Vidar, for your submission. Next, we have submission by Benedict, a.k.a. Velocity, who, just crazy, kind of abstract thing going on, very cool. Took the outside of the lines and made it, gave it that multiple layered kind of a 3D effect there. A lot of different colors and splattering and painting going on. And then we have one little person down here. Looks like they punched out. Looks like they might be stuck inside the letter. Maybe they punched it out and they're like, oh, there's an outside or something. But that's my interpretation there, which is the cool thing about art. You create, the person creates what they might think of what, you know, they see, and then it's always up for interpretation. So thank you, Benedict. Very cool. Next, we have a submission by Benjamin Patient, ID number 94070269, who took this very horrible-looking monster creature and then add a little effect to it to give it like a waxy kind of look, and then took outside the lines and did that extruding type of 3D with different colors. So kind of a whole plastic extruding waxy kind of thing going on. So of course a very flattering image of myself, of course. So thank you, Benjamin. Next, a submission by Carson, who just another random kind of thing going on. Lots of lines at different angles, some arrows, some stars, some lines here, white lines to give the little shiny effect, make them, you know, a little 3D effect there, a couple black diamonds and such. So very cool, very different, and that's just fine. So thank you, Carson, for your submission. Next we have by another Carson, or maybe the same Carson. They painted around an empty canvas and just left the canvas blank, and then just hand painted and took a picture of it. So very cool, and quite something that you know, I would do. I would you know, I like very outside the box, outside the canvas, so to speak. And then just added the outside the lines there, just so we know it's for this little project. Next we have by someone by the name Clervis Clemens, comes from a another dimension. It's an alternate universe of the original Corvus. I recently completed the assignment assigned to me and am presenting it to you in this email. It may have taken a few weeks to research and compose, but I believe the finished product will be to your liking. So we have a lot of, I don't know what's going on, maybe a little dog here, eyeball, someone here, I'm not sure exactly who that is, a rubber chicken here, Corvus over there, tin foil over the T, brain here, maybe for the E, leaking out, who knows what, redacted, black book there, this letter is covered in nothing, a lot of video games here, Dark Souls, Bloodborne, Demon's Souls, Skyrim, blah, blah, blah. And I think a lot of the games that I probably played, or that we all have played, and then to do spend a little too much time on a drawing for the person who's helped me sleep and calm down throughout the years. So very cool, very different. So, and just, I love it. So thank you, Clervis Clemens. Next, a submission by Cloud, patient ID number 6610001, who says it took this opportunity to make a little art project to show everyone how much I'm enjoying my stay here at Arkham Sanitarium. So we have a kind of a beveled outside the lines going on, a little bit transparent. We can see maybe the professor right there. Yeah, that's the professor. A lot of black. There's a horror kind of thing going on here. A very wonderful, nice dark illustrations. Down here it says they're watching in the trees. Cut it there, and let's see. Cut the red string. Okay, cut the red string. So there's a red string going through there, and we have Margaret. Two different types of Margarets going on. Side profile. One very, very something darker side of Margaret and a lighter side. So thank you, Cloud, for your submission. Next we have from Clown, or Clome, however you want to say it. We have a lot going on here. Just all kinds of crazy randomness going on here. Lots of little details, little family or something there in the eye, scribbles, and never gonna give you up, never gonna let you down, never gonna run around and desert you. So there we go, a mouse over here, and inside the lines there. So Stonks, Jesse or Walter Bismarck, there we go. So crazy craziness, and I love it. So thank you, Clown, Clome, whatever. Next, a submission by Darnell, who, another little crazy mess going on. Blue all over here, and some black, and looks like a side profile of like a creature with dreadlocks, or a shadow with arms and eyes trying to take over there, and some mess over here, and I don't know what's going on, but that's perfectly fine. I wasn't asking for anything in particular, just to do something, and this person did something, for sure. Scribbles and blah, 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 so that's perfect. There we go, so thank you, Darnell. Next, we have Dave from Italy, who says, lines, what lines? Where is the outside and where is the inside? So they took the original outside, the lines, which you can see right here, a little bit outside the lines, and I think they drew over all of it, obviously, with a felt tip marker, I'm assuming. I think this was printed out, took a picture of it, or maybe digital. It doesn't look, I don't think it's digital. It's like with a picture, with a camera. Anyway, so there's just a lot of great detail. Left the lines alone and the question mark. Well, added a question mark. And it did so many lines that made the outside and the disappear. You know, until you take a good look at it. So like an optical illusion kind of thing going on. So very cool, very different. Thank you, Dave. Next, we have a submission by Decaf Math ASMR, who is an ASMR creator, so you should be able to look Decaf Math up on YouTube. Okay, so we have a tree, and we have ampersands, SM, ASMR with ampersands, good night apples with Z's, Hello Kitty with tinfoil, Spot the pet boot, patient ID number there, good meow instead of good now. And then over here, an old reference, The Insomnia Killer's Serenity Journal. I think I did a video called The Insomnia Killer. I don't know, it's been a while. I can't remember everything. I don't even write down all the things I did. And then Earth Human's Last Requests. So there we go, so very cool. And this looks like it's been printed out and hand drawn or painted. So thank you, Decaf Math, for your submission. Next, we have a submission by Derp Dog, who says, when my parts need maintenance, I go to see the repairman. When I need a medical checkup, I go to Margaret. And when I need a place to stay, I seek refuge in the Arkham Sanitarium. So we have a lot going on here. Different references, different videos, rubber chicken again. This is very cool, very creative. Took quite a long time, I think. There is the Dead by Daylight Jeff roleplay. Pineapple, Ethan Pineapple. I don't know what's going over here with the L. That's very cool, though. But, a lot going on here. The brain up there, the microphone, cutting mat, tinfoil, TV set up with the rubber chicken, keeping watch, another book, so rubber ducky. So very cool. Thank you, Derp Dog, for your submission. Patient ID D1123325. All right, next submission by DXC from Albania, who I think may have forgotten or intentionally left out the outside the lines. No big deal. Very nice illustration of Corvus looking outside the window or the lines. So, thank you, DXC. Next, we have from Emma, who took outside the lines and did a bunch of random stuff, kind of a nature thing. We have the sun. We have, like, a fruiting bush or tree up here with apples or something. A tree down here. Looks like the L down here has grid lines in it. Makes me think of a building or a skyscraper on the horizon, you know, on the beach or something, hotel, and waves. So very simple, but that's, you know, what I like sometimes about something that can be quite simple. Just, you can still get an idea of what's trying to be expressed. So thank you, Emma, for your contribution. Very nice. Next we have, this is the second from Emma, but this one is by Ben. So I'm not sure if maybe two people or both are by Ben, but I don't know. They didn't really say how to mention them. So we have Emma or Ben or both. This one is a grid on the background with a kind of like a a sun kind of effect or space thing or flower just radiating out here from the center on the line. So again, thank you for that. Next we have submission by Emmy, patient number 3339713390007. And they took outside the lines and hollowed it out and then put it out into like a space kind of thing. We have a planet here with a ring, maybe another planet or an apple, or who knows what's going on here. All kinds of stuff. And then looks like we have a snowman here in the corner. So interesting looking effect there in the background. Kind of very somewhat abstract and different kind of things going on. And so I'm not much of a critique or anything, but my vocabulary is limited. But thank you, Emmy. Very cool and different, as all of these are. That's what's so awesome here. Just it's so different from one person to the next. And again, don't feel like, you know, don't compare yourself. Now, this is not what this is about, okay? So, all right, next we have by Esoteric. Just a bunch of random stuff kind of going on here, different things. We have Corvus, we have, Cthulhu up here maybe, Nintendo Switch, a monster here, Praying Mantis, maybe a snake or a sea serpent, Pink Floyd, I think, reference right here, the Dark Side of the Moon maybe, you know, going on there, snake and different stuff. Caterpillar kind of looking ladybug, not a caterpillar, ladybug there. So very cool and very nice. So thank you, Esoteric. Next we have from Ethan, who looks like they took the original outside the lines and then kind of added some effects to it, made the outside coming down a little bit and then the lines coming up. So a different kind of 3D kind of thing going on. And then Drew, it's like a bit of abstract stuff going on with a sun maybe in the top left, rays, and then lots of different colors. And I'm not really well-versed on the different types of art styles, but I'll just say it's abstract, very colorful, and very nice. So thank you, Ethan, for your submission. Next, we have one by Fable. Patient ID number 0018. Fable says, 0018 has begun to stare for hours through the keyhole in her room. This behavior is very out of line for her. Increased security recommended. Maybe another padlock. I heard she doesn't make a sound when she walks. So they took outside the lines, printed it out, cut out all the letters, and then did this other little painting in the back of an eyeball. Very cool, very different, and experimental, and I love it. So, assuming they are a painter of some kind like that, I don't think I could have done something like that. I'm not very good at blending colors and things like that myself. So, very cool, very nice. So, thank you, Fable, for your submission. Next, we have submission by Philbot. I think it's called Fear, something like that. They took outside the lines, added that kind of 3D blocky effect going on there, and then put the lampshade man in the back, and then added this kind of dark, creepy forest texture thing going on. So maybe the whole theme here is fear. That's kind of the vibe I can see going on that they might have been going for. So very cool, very different, and I should bring back the lampshade guy sometime or something. Anyway, so thank you, Philbot. Next submission is by FX Walzer, who says, a drawing with a soft pencil on white paper, then I took a photo and reversed the colors. The body shapes are something I used to draw on my school stuff, like staplers and notebooks, during lessons. Of course, we all doodle and draw during school. That's the best time to do it. So, lots of different stuff going on here. someone trying to hold up the earth, a postcard there, someone looking down at a mountain, maybe, that's what I get. I don't know what's going on here with that one, but yeah, this is all kind of cool. Car crashing into a tree, someone maybe with a cigarette down there, mountains, a scene going on, like maybe Corvus down here with a clipboard, so clouds and such, so maybe a squash right in there, I don't know what's going on, pumpkin, yeah, maybe that's what that is, I don't know, but very cool, so thank you, FX Walzer, for your submission. Next submission by George, patient number T615161922. And took the outside lines and added, looks like did three different things going on here. Painted the outside with this one particular texture. We can see that. And then did like a airbrush effect with the. And then took lines and did a, I don't know, splatter kind of thing going on. So that's very cool and very different. And I like it, a little bit of color, then maybe not so much color down here. A lot of different contrasting kind of experimental stuff going on. So very cool. Nice. Thank you, George, for your submission. Next we have by Glitchy, patient number 456529, who obviously looks like they did an underwater scene. We have outside the lines in an aquarium. We have some bubbles. We have a couple of, well, not goldfish, but yeah, I used to know what these types of fish were. They have the long fins and are quite colorful. And some underwater vegetation as well. So thank you, Glitchy. Very nice. Next, we have a submission by Goose, patient number 16254980, who did a very kind of, like a pastel kind of look, kind of faded, all one, within one kind of color range with a little bit of green, some faded colors, like a man's suit with like a Illuminati, that's what I think of, pyramid head. Some eyes going on there, and squiggle lines, different types of texture there with the, and a tree. So I'm not sure if this any of this is a reference to anything or just completely random. Either way, I like it. So thank you, Goose. Next, by Guybert, we have Rift, I beg you, let me out of your basement. Yeah, nice try. I don't think so. But anyway, you know what? I probably shouldn't be showing this on YouTube. No, it's okay. I mean, no one's going to show this to the authorities or anything. So, yeah, hold on a second. You okay, Guybert? I think they're asleep right now. Anyway, yeah, so there we go. Not much more to say there. Let's just move on, shall we? Next, we have Haterbix1314, who took outside the lines and turned into a, I'm not sure if this is Roblox, but I have a feeling it is, but it's not Lego, but, and then turned me into a Roblox thing or whatever this game is. I'm going to say Roblox, but I don't know. There's an explosion. Then we have this, looks like Lego thing going on, whatever, but very cool and very different. So, yeah, whatever this theme is, it's, I like it. So, thank you, Haterbix, for your submission. Next, we have a submission from Henry Luli, who's also on YouTube. Did it outside the lines. Very simple, but very colorful and just fine as well. Not everything, you know, again, doesn't have to be a, no, it's not a competition or anything. So, just took some lines and redid, wrote the outside lines inside of the outside the lines, and then took some, you know, little diagonals of different colors and up outside the line, outside in lines, nice colors going on, but then the is just gray and some black, so simple but yet creative, and that's just fine for this whole project. So thank you, Henry, for your contribution. Next, we have one by Jeff, who took outside the lines and did maybe there's supposed to be blood, or who knows what. I might think that is. Everything is just kind of oozing or bleeding. Or at least that's my take. Or maybe it's pasta sauce. Maybe someone poured spaghetti sauce over everything. Yeah, who knows? But I like it. Outside the lines, and then added all this pouring over, running down, and pooling at the bottom. So, very nice, very cool. So, thank you, Jeff. Again, just trying to get through all these as quickly as possible. Next, we have a submission by Jeremy P. of Sector C. I'm not really sure. Maybe it's another video game. I'm not sure. I'm kind of clueless. Or just a random image grabbed and turned into a meme kind of thing. But I'm assuming I see these outside the lines, little orange things, and I don't know, it makes me think of something. I can't place it. But either way, so face there. So thank you, Jeremy, for your contribution. Next, very cool, we have by Joel, who took outside the lines and kind of inverted it, and then just, this is very neat, took all these different random, you know, some random spots and circles, you know, filled in the background, I guess you might say, just reversed it. It's the only thing I can say, kind of an abstract thing going on, different colors. You can just kind of make out outside the lines there. That's a very cool, unique little take. I don't think there's anything else like this here in this project by anyone else, but that's what's cool. Everyone had their own unique little thing to do, no matter how simple or much effort they put in. So thank you, Joel. Very nice. Next, we have Jumi. Jumi writes, "My favorite character is likely a common pick, but Corvus is very likable. What a generous guy curing the words in this picture here." Okay, so that's what's going on. Corvus is curing. So we have outside the lines, and I guess the outside the lines have been taken over by some kind of horrible creatures and demons with eyes and fangs, and Corvus is curing the letters and the words. So very nice of Corvus. You can see injecting the same fluid in the needle. You can see it going to work in the lines. So very cool, very different, and thank you, Jumi. Next, by JTP, who took a portion of outside the lines, cropped it out, and just worked with one little section, which is very different and experimental, and I love it. And then it has these little, looks like this might be a picture they took of it, or maybe it's all digital, doesn't really matter. I might be trying to enlarge it here. Divisi Eternal, I'm not sure what that means, Eternal. I don't know. I'm not going to begin to guess, embarrass myself. But yeah, very different and very abstract and experimental. Cool. No idea what this is down here, but it's just different. So I like it. So thank you, JDB. Next, a submission by Julia. I think they told me that they printed it out and then penciled it with all these different designs. I'm trying to think of the type of design this is. I used to do something very basic like this years ago, where you try to do the same type of design over and over, repeating patterns, and I forget the name of that, but that's what they did here. Very cool, lots of very colorful ducks, a roulette wheel, it looks like, and very, very nice, and a lot of effort and work put into that, so wonderful stuff. So thank you, Julia, for your submission. Next, we have by Catherine, almost the same idea going on. They printed it out and then colored it in with maybe marker. Looks like black outside the lines, contrasting the colorful little floral design going on. Spirals, like grass, I guess you could say, and lots of blues, pinks, and very colorful, and I like it. So, very nice. A lot of effort there as well, but that doesn't matter, of course. Maximum effort or little effort. Now, that's not really what this is all about, but thank you, Catherine, for your submission. Next, we have a submission by Chaotic, or Cow X, K-O-X. At first, first that looks like I just saw a tree with strawberries, but then we actually have a woman of color here with some red lips that match her big green afro, with strawberries and flowers in it with outside the lines, just kind of sitting in there a little bit. And her body is the tree. So this is very cool, very different and unique. We have a rainbow kind of colorful thing, gradient going on in the background, which is very nice. So this is very different and I like it. So again, this is what I love about what everybody did is, this is all about you and them, you know, really, it's just really cool. So thank you, Chaotic, for your submission. Next we have Kyle, who looks like a Pokemon theme here. Either drew this, I'm not sure if they drew this. I'm gonna assume either they drew it or they copy and pasted some stuff. I don't know. I don't think Kyle told me, but it's fine. By the way, and they took outside the lines. I wasn't expecting people to do a lot of work, you know? But yeah, so we have Pikachu floating on some balloons. I'm not sure who this is. Down in the right corner, maybe a Pokemon character from a TV show or video game, pointing to outside the lines with a nice little kind of 3D effect going on there in the background a little bit. So very cool, very nice. So thank you, Kyle, for your submission. Next submission by Kyubi, I think is how we pronounce it. They say, I found you late one night when my insomnia was preventing me from getting any shut-eye. Ever since then, I've been a long-time member of Arkham Sanitarium. My patient number is 800-8462. So they took outside the lines and added a bunch of slime to it. Lots of colors and very colorful as well. A little bit of bright green and pink makes it look somewhat neon kind of effect going on there, and very nice. So simple, but different. And that's what's cool about it, how each person, again, their own unique take and what they want to do with it. So thank you, Kyubi, for your contribution. Next we have image by LL Niles, also known as Abhor Nightmares on Twitter, I think. This is oil and digital. So they originally did an oil painting and then took a picture of it and then did some additional work digitally. You can see all the different strokes, I guess, from the brush or the knife. Maybe they used the knife there, hard to tell. I'm not an expert, but different gradients of a red and orange kind of thing going on a little bit. Gives off a little bit of a different kind of vibe, I think. So thank you, LL Niles, for your submission. Next by Landon, who took outside the lines and just kind of added some effects here, made it blurry and bendy and warped, and added some random scribbles and different splatters and this whole kind of vignette yellow kind of thing going on, as if maybe you're viewing this whole thing from underwater or something. I don't know. Then we have a little skull and a little S down there or something. Very cool and very different. And yeah, so thank you, Landon, for your submission. Next we have a submission by Lane, or Rendane, who took the outside the lines and did this, I want to say, kind of psychedelic. It reminds me of a particular art style, but I don't know, but it's got all the different, the angles and lines, and they change, as the angles, that everything changes color, kaleidoscope kind of effect. Over here, the O is completely different. We have a night scene, trees and stars and a moon, and the universe kind of thing with stars maybe and something like that, and multicolored and bright and a lot of different contrasting colors and all that. So very cool and different. So thank you, Lane, for your submission. Next we have a submission by Laurie, who made this little happy little outdoor nature scene. We have the sun and a flower and a bee, very long noses or proboscises, and they all flying around, hanging out, and seem very content, and nice little river going on here. Different colors and shades, and the sunset or maybe sunrise. Hard to tell. Maybe sunset because it's getting dark up top. Maybe hard to tell though. Could be dark because it was night. Very nice, very different and unique, and I like it. So thank you, Laurie, for your submission. Next we have Leilani, who looks like they printed it out and colored it with crayon. We have someone over here walking, and over here we have free thought and individuality forbidden. So maybe this is like a school. In the background there, we have a little girl over here. She seems very happy, or maybe she just looks that way because she's been brainwashed by whatever's going on back here in that building. But yeah, very colorful. Red, orange, and green, blue, and purple, and black, and so very different and unique. So thank you, Leilani, for your submission. Next, we have a submission by Mackenzie, who did a bunch of random stuff here. Some suns, star, heart. Let's see, we have some character names here from different videos on my channel. Corvus, Deep One, Dave, Margaret, Iggy, Professor Clemens, Rubber Chicken, Cthulhu, Benjamin, Grandpa, Dr. Shade, Charlie Carl, and The Man. And again, I never asked anyone to do anything like that, so. But references to different characters. Very cool little interpretation of the outside the lines. And of course, we also have a bunch of Z's here to represent sleep. So apparently they get a lot of sleep, maybe, watching the different characters put them to sleep. So thank you, Mackenzie, for your submission. Next, we have one by Madeline, who did this kind of, vector, maybe not vector, but whatever this is with the angles and everything. I don't even know how they would have done that, but it's very cool and detailed, and it's kind of very, the outside the lines you can see has these shapes going through it, but there's no color, but then outside the lines there is color. So just a very cool effect that's going on here. Kind of stylish and different colors gradiating from like purple and blue over to yellow and orange and red, kind of thing going on with some white space there, and very different and neat. So thank you, Madeline, for your contribution. Next we have one by Mario, who illustrated Deep One Dave, a character on the channel, and then took outside the lines, superimposed it, but actually no, kind of, there's a lot going on here. We have outside the lines in white when it's outside of beyond Dave, and then Dave is red, kind of, you know, a little bit in the dark with the black background, but then you see when Dave crosses with the certain letters, he appears in his, you know, green, fishy form. So it's like three different things going on. So it's very cool and very different and nice illustration of Dave. I'm sure Dave will like this. So thank you, Mario, for your submission. Next, we have an illustration submission by Michi Cookies, aka Vinny, who says, I decided to try my hand at your coloring page using a couple of my characters. I recently got an iPad as a graduation gift, so I decided to try drawing on it as practice. And I think they did really good for practice. I guess their own character here is Leekina. I'm assuming, I know these are like Pokemon type of characters. I'm going to make that assumption. And then we have another character type. I'm not really sure what that is. Michi Cookies is saying this is a Twilight McNull who's looking up at a Leekina. Okay, very cool. And of course, the Leekina is grabbing on to the outside the lines. And the Twilight McNull is kind of looking on in surprise. Simple, yet stylish, you know, just not much going on except for the two characters, which is cool. So thank you, Michi Cookies. Next submission by Mighty Cactus. We have outside the lines with some kind of abstract thing going on with some different texture applied there. Like a frosty, icy thing maybe going on. And then some wavy looking designs there, and then in the background we have this kind of grid going on with a gradient effect, colored effect, and very cool and very different. And so there we go. That is by Mighty Cactus. So thank you for your submission. Next by Misha, or Meowmo on Twitter, who took outside the lines and then in the background painted this like mountain kind of scene with tall trees, evergreens, perhaps, and maybe a little clouds, kind of purplish kind of effect in the sky, and the sun is somewhere in the background there, maybe, and some clouds. It looks like, yeah, some clouds. The white stuff, I guess, is clouds. Some fog, maybe, down here. So very cool. So thank you, Misha, for your contribution. Next, we have one by Monkey, who I think might like bananas. A very monkey banana, you know, return to monkey kind of thing going on here. Yellow and brown for the ends. Every letter is supposed to be like a banana, with the yellow coloring and then the brown tips of the banana. So lots of bananas there. So I'm assuming Monkey likes bananas, is a monkey, or both. So there we go. Simple, colorful, and fun. So thank you, Monkey, for your submission. Next, we have Mortal Mayhem, aka Hidden Yoshi. Oh, no, I'm sorry. There is a Hidden Yoshi in here, right there. So there is Hidden Yoshi hanging out between inside the lines, or sorry, outside the lines. So we have some green going on there, and then changes to black, and then we have colors, little scribbled kind of colors going on there with the lines. So I'm assuming this could be a Yoshi, kind of. I know Yoshi is green, so maybe there's that kind of a thing going on here, a Yoshi theme a little bit, or not, I don't know. Forgot to mention, says my patient ID has at least 17 in it at all times, but I can never keep track of it. It keeps running off. Please bring it to the lost and found if you can manage to catch it. So, thank you, Mortal Mayhem, for your submission. Next, by Mr. Elospo or something, I'm not really sure. We have outside the lines, and in the background, we have all kinds of crazy, I don't know, different lines, abstract, different colors, going all kinds of different ways. And, like, I don't know, straws or confetti, string, straw, whatever it might be going on. And perfectly random, chaotic, and different. And that's just fine. And I like it. So thank you, Mr. Elozapo, for your submission. Next submission is by Nata, who has this pastel color kind of thing going on, a little kind of faded, also known as Riva Tunrala on Instagram, if you'd like to check them out. Yeah, we have the outside the lines in this kind of, ooh, I can't think of the color, like a dark purple, and then we have like different flowers, kind of a floral effect going on here with, I would say, plants, trees, kind of like a very floral thing going on with the kind of pastel kind of colors a little bit. So very nice. I like it. And different. So thank you, Nata, for your submission. Next, we have something by Necrobinacle Astercorte. This is outside the lines with the very, they have outside, written in out in all the letters of outside, and then the, in the, and then lines is just L-I-N-E-S, each letter written again in its own letter, but the words up there, even outside in the I of, or the dot of the I. there, and some different little colors going on here, from orange and like brown to pink and purple. So a little gray there on a little diagonal. So very neat and very different. So thank you, Necrobinacle, for your contribution submission. Next we have by Necrotic, who did a whole bunch of crazy random stuff here, illustrating almost every letter there. I'm not sure who this is in the background. I want to say I should know a character from a video game. I don't know if that's a Half-Life character. That's the G-Man. It looks familiar, but we have some people looking on here. And then we have just a crow with a pentagram, Cthulhu sign pointing towards Arkham Sanitarium, a Nintendo controller or something, PlayStation, I don't know, like a Stay Puft Marshmallow Man demon version, trees, and a crazy thing with eyes, and a Lego person, and a monster there, and the NWO banning everything, and Corvus's mask hung over the O in the background there, forest, and I'm not sure what this E is, but very different and unique, and a lot of effort put into that. So thank you very much, Necrotic, for your submission. Very cool. And again, I wish I could spend more time, like 5 minutes, you know, or, you know, a couple minutes going over everyone's, but, you know, there's so many submissions that we're probably here for an hour already. Well, we're almost done. I think we're about 75%, 80% through here. This next one is by Neo. This is the Stanley Parable video game theme. So we have the path that you see, that you follow sometimes in the video game, the broom closet, and 427, which is your room number. The end is never the end, is never the end, is never the end. The Stanley Parable adventure line. I just started playing the Stanley Parable about a month ago before I started playing Evil Dead the game. But I got to a couple of the endings. I'm not sure how many there are, but I've seen like 3 or 4 of the endings. But it's a very cool video game, and I might have to do a video on it somehow. I'm not sure, but yeah, so very cool. And so thank you, Neo, for your Stanley Parable submission. And next we have a submission by Non-Incident. This is Howard Hamlin, who is from the TV show Better Call Saul, which I absolutely love, which is a prequel to Breaking Bad, and they are actually coming out with a prequel to Better Call Saul, Slippin' Jimmy, I believe it's going to be. So yeah, very cool. Outside the Lines with Howard Hamlin, everybody's favorite, looking on ominously in a very distrusting manner. So thank you, non-incident. Next, we have a little illustration going on here by Norge1. Also, Norge.graph at Instagram, who took a bunch of monsters that are destroying the outside the lines. It looks like this monster ate the E. We have like a mouse picking away, claw there, another monster there, small monsters here. This is the kind of stuff that I love. Not that it's any better than anyone else has done, but I always loved myself personally. Little details, these kind of illustrations where you just look closer and closer, and oh, there's something over here, and oh, I never saw that before, you know. I've always loved this kind of stuff. So yeah, very cool. This little monster ate all the way into the U, bird and a goblin and all of it, and a little kraken kind of monster, Cthulhu maybe, pulling down the E and the S. So very awesome. So thank you, Norge1, for your submission. Next person, this is Otto, who took the outside the lines and made it very sparkly there, a little transparent as well. We have some tentacles. Looks like we are in Margaret's garden. We have the sanitarium in the background. We have Corvus right here behind Margaret. Margaret has a little flower there, or plant. And there's a rubber chicken there, cone, something down here in the shadows a little bit. We have something right here. I'm not sure what's going on there, what that is, but very cool tentacles, something hiding over here. We have a shovel and a night scene here going on, and Professor Clemens over here casually watching on, and a brain buried in the garden. So there we go. So very awesome, very cool. And thank you, Otto, for your submission. Don't mean to go through these so quickly, but I have to. Kind of pressed for time with all these submissions. Here is by Owen, who took outside the lines and just scribbled and made a crazy, chaotic mess. All kinds of different colors and some thin lines, some broad strokes, different colors, and kind of going around outside the lines, kind of going in between, going over it a little bit, and a perfect, wonderful little thing. So thank you, Owen, for your masterpiece that I'm sure Michelangelo would be very impressed by. Next, by Patch, patient ID number 331612038, who says, I had some fun with all of my colored pencils and gradients. It was nice just to sit down and color something for the hell of it. And that's what they did. So they printed it out and used their colored pencils and did a much better job than I did. They did a nice gradient effect. I think when I did this, it was just one color, solid. I didn't really do too much of an artistic thing. It takes time to color something like this. It can take, you know, a couple hours. And so I had to, when I was doing it myself, the first video, I just wanted to make it simple. It was more about the you know, the coloring sound and everything. Anyway, so gradients and different colors and nice little background colored in as well, different colors as well, but not quite as bright as the colors. So very cool, nice and contrasting colors. So thank you, Patch, for your submission. Next submission by patient number 130698, who basically did what some other folks did, which is kind of neat how some people think thought the same thing, and they took inside and they wrote inside of all the letters of outside the lines. So inside, and we have a bunch of O's right there. And then we have a person here saying inside. So, and some scribbles there, different colors for all the words, a little happy face in the E. And yeah, very simple and fun, and that's all it's about. So thank you, patient number 130698, for your submission. Next, we have a submission from Pine, who did like an illustration here, Corvus. And this is the stuff that I wish I could draw. But yeah, this is, you know, this is very cool. Monster hands, all kinds of things going on here. We have a factory here, people, punk rockers or something going on there. Candy, maybe different candy man, men, whatever, monster. Another thing down here, vote NWO, less is more. Yeah, so lots of different references. So very cool. So thank you, Pine, for your submission. Next is Rent for Car Live patient ID number 453, who also did a video of this, which we'll get to in a little bit. They took outside the lines and just did their own little rainbow thing going on, drawing inside, outside the lines as well, which we've seen some other folks do, which is very cool. So I'll show you the video in a little bit. Get to the video soon. And moving on to Rice Crispy, who did a, I'm not really sure what's going on here. I'm assuming these two are like stick figures fighting each other, and this one killed the other one. He's on the high ground, got a blue sword or a dagger, and this one's now dead. So, I mean, or it's a red string or a worm, I don't know. But that's my assumption. And then they took this nice little colored the background a little bit with some green, some like off yellow there, mustard, and some teal. And so there we go. And so thank you, Rice Crispy, for your submission. Next we have by Rider Outside the slimes. Very cool. I'm not sure what these two people are, if this is a reference to anything or this is just a random drawing doodle. This one has, like, I don't know, an eye stalk growing out of their head or something there. Outside the lines, but then they added an S, turned the N into an M. So that's cool. Wasn't expecting that. So it's all oozing and dripping slime with a little cloud sky scene in the background and floating heads. So thank you, Ryder, for your submission. Next submission by Sam, who did this crazy chaotic energy kind of thing going on. It looks like, I don't know how you describe it, like a nuclear reaction going on or explosion. And we have outside the lines distorted. Of course, this is my interpretation. Then we have this yellow square, which looks like pieces of it are falling off. So I don't really know what's trying to be conveyed here, but whatever it is, you know, we're all going to look at this and see something different. So very cool. I just feel like a lot of energy is going on with this distortion and stuff. So thank you, Sam, for your submission. Next, we have one by Screwy Louie, patient ID 4046621, who says, just had an appointment with Corvus last Monday. Don't know what he keeps in that closet of his in the corner of his room, but I heard a lot of noise coming from it during our session. Whatever it is, the thing must have enjoyed the sound of Corvus's gloves, just like I had. So there we go, we have something trying to get out of the closet there, Corvus, in Corvus's little office with a skull on his desk, and a chart, maybe a human brain over here, some symbols, and, you know, one of those kind of things you're not really supposed to understand what's being written about and all that. And there is Corvus in all of his glorious splendor, black and white little illustration, doesn't say outside the lines, which is fine. You know, some folks might not have understood that they needed to include outside the lines, but, you know, I'm not going to be, it's not that big of a deal. But there we go. Thank you, Screwy Louie, for your submission as well. Next, we have a submission by Sentoki Suzuki, who, I don't know, we have some kind of anime thing going on here. I'm not sure, maybe some of you might recognize the character. I'm not sure if this is just a copy and paste of something else or they drew this themselves. I don't know. But we took outside the lines, and then we have one particular anime character from one particular show in the background there. And I'm not sure, again, which show or character this is or what scene or if this is supposed to represent anything. Maybe it is their favorite show or character. But there we go. So thank you, Sentoki, for your submission. Next, we have one by Shauna. A lot of more insane craziness going on. We have Cthulhu, we have Corvus, and with his face kind of disfigured behind the mask, which is why we never see, maybe why we never see Corvus without his mask. A hand over here, Cthulhu blocks, Eldritch blocks, and a lot of crazy stuff going on here that I like. I love the darker stuff, kind of flesh-toned kind of things here, hairy, the, going on. So, I love it, very cool, and thank you, Shauna, for your submission. Next submission by Smug, says, outside the lines, look at this freaking dog, they say. And I'm assuming maybe that's their dog, or it's a random dog off the internet, I don't know. Outside the lines, added some color to it, and then pasted it right over that dog. I don't know, is that a Yorkie or a terrier kind of dog going on there? Very cool. Look at this freaking dog. All right, so thank you, Smug, for your submission. Not everything had to be, you know, an illustration, so that's perfectly cool, and I like it. Next, we have by Sprato Potus Bengt, who says they're... who wrote a whole big thing here and says, I'm from Sirius, located in certain space coordinates. I escaped from Area 51 last month and was rescued by a 2.8-meter tall, gray, four-legged creature with one long trunk and two enormous ears, elephant, currently staying in the underground. ground somewhere in Southeast Asia watching your video and planning to go back to Sirius. So we have outside the lines a giant tomato. I'm not sure if this is just an illustration they did or, you know, copy and paste, whatever. I don't really care. It's fine. But so there we go. Sprato Podesmengt. Thank you for your submission and your giant tomato, which I'm not really sure if that's supposed to be anything or just completely random and goofy and silly, which is just fine. So, all right, moving on to a submission by Steven. This Steven actually painted their little quick representation of the trans flag. Steven says, I made the drawing a trans flag because A, why not? And B, trans people do funky things with gender outside of the line of normalcy. And I didn't know this, but FYI, I had to Google this, but the transgender flag is a light blue, pink, and white pentacolor pride flag representing the transgender community, organizations, and individuals. It was designed by American trans woman Monica Helms in 1999, 23 years ago, and I'm not sure if I ever knew that or not. I mean, about the flag. So that's very cool. So outside the lines kind of thing there with the flag. So very nice. So thank you, Stephen, for your submission. Next submission by subject ID 5017, aka the dude with a literal 2 second attention span. So they try to do something, but every time they try to draw it, they get tired and bored and move on to drawing something else. Okay, I'm bored now. The gamer here. Okay, I'm bored again. I gave him a mole. Happy face with a mole. Get stick bugged or stick bug. Nintendo. Scribbles. I'm gonna draw Arkham Sanitarium. Welcome to Ugh. I'm bored again. So yeah, so that's me. Sometimes your brain is just not focused and on so many different things. So very cool, and a little outlet there, and the Nintendo gets plugged in all the way across there and everything. So there we go. All right, so thank you, subject ID 5017. Next submission by Tasty Apple, who yellow background and kind of interesting looking design here. I'm not sure how to describe it, but some stars in the, and then some different colors and the way they did the different designs around the T and the S and the letters. They put those little extra lines in there and then separate it from the main color. So I like that. Very different and cool and quite colorful. So thank you, Tasty Apple, for your submission. Next we have Thena, patient number 778, who did like another nature kind of thing, this pastel kind of colors. We have bumblebees here flying around, flowers, and that's what I like about abstract stuff. You can just create the very kind of basic look of the things, but you get the idea of what's going on without actually having to draw a very detailed flower with an equally detailed, you know, bumblebee. But that's what I got here. That's what I think is going on. We have some bumblebees, you know, flying around here. The head of the bumblebee, the body, and the wings right up top there. And, yeah, and the flowers and the stems and the path of the bumblebee there. So that's what I think it is, and I'm going to go with that. So thank you, Thena, for your submission. Next, we have one by Title. T-I-T-E-L, another kind of Rift World, Ephemeral Rift Universe type of thing going on. We have Margaret down here planting she successfully planted something in the desert, Cone of Calm. Deep One Dave over here with the squash and potato, Kevin. We have like somebody running from a sandworm. Corvus and the professor holding on to the sandworm. A dog and a gopher and tinfoil and a rubber chicken and a pirate and ripped again and a keyboard synthesizer going on there and all that, and Arkham Sanitarium in the back. So, and cartel guy right there, the microphone or something right there. So very cool, very detailed. The pet boot. So awesome. So great work. Vidal, however you want to pronounce that, for your submission. Next, we have one by Top Quality Music's Little Sidekick Goblin. A lot of more random craziness going on here. Outside the lines there, Microphone Eagle, just a whole bunch of, like a collage, chaotic, crazy, insane collage, and I love it. And then why is my spoon a fork, or my fork a spoon, a potato, and Professor Clement and a laptop, and all kinds of stuff. There's the black and white video, all that windmill. We have another random book here. I'm not sure what that is. It's something lampshade there. A lot of crazy digital mess here, and all of that, and line segment endpoint. So very, very cool. I like it. Love it. So thank you, Top Quality Music, Little Sidekick Goblin. Next by Tori, aka Alarai or Alo. We have here, looks like they printed this out and then used colored markers to design it. Outside the lines, we have repeating colors going on a diagonal in the background. Very nice. So it looks like outside the lines is over the background. And then we have different little triangles, red, and then like orange dots. So, and then some lines, yellow lines. So very different and unique, and I like it, and colorful, and contrasting colors, and, you know, the background is doing one thing, then inside the letters we have something else going on. And Tori also says this was actually very therapeutic to do, as I had a stressful day. So again, thank you, Tori, for your submission. Next submission by Valentin, who says, the snail took my patient ID. Valentin described to me that there is a snail that ate the lines. So that's why the L is down here in like a pool of blood. And the I-N-E-S is gone. So outside the coming, maybe the snail is coming. I don't know. So we have like some McDonald's thing going on, beer, Monster Energy drink, and I don't know what's going on with the D there. It looks like it's a creature itself. Maybe that's the snail head. I don't know. Little person over here. So very cool and different, and I could go for McDonald's now. But yeah, so they just got rid of the lines, and all that's left is the L lying in its own pool of blood. So very cool and different. So thank you, Valentin, for your submission. So next submission is by Watching Atlas 09, who did a like random kind of thing going on with like a dragon up here with wings and random streaks of blue and diamond things with pointy parts sticking out, and I don't know, maybe some blood down here and some green something, and I don't know, maybe a person here. There's a bunch of stuff going on that I like it. It's different, and it's what they wanted to do with it, and it's a work of art. So thank you, Watching Atlas 09, for your submission. Moving on next to William, who obviously printed out outside the lines and then just took some markers, crumpled it up, spread it back out, uncrumpled it, and then, or you know, drew on it first and then crumpled it, I guess. Just a bunch of random crazy lines, different colors, scribbles, chaotic mess, and just a bunch of randomness and experimental, and that's all that I could have asked for. So another beautiful work of art. Oh, and William also states they sort of stumbled into the community post about this little project and created this while drinking tea, eating a pastry, and going on a spiritual journey, so to speak. So thank you, William, for your submission. Next we have Worldwide Webster, who drew outside the lines, and I don't know what any of this might reference. Warhammer stuff. Someone mentioned Warhammer, I think. I'm not sure if this is that, but anyway, we have gray and green, and all kinds of the colors are match up with these little two graphic images of whatever they're from, which I don't know, but a lot of electric, kind of, I imagine, like, electricity, green power going on here. So very cool and different and a theme of something that I don't know. So thank you, Worldwide Webster. Next, we have Yoshi222022, who printed out outside the lines, cut it out, colored it in with some really kind of abstract different diagonals and squiggles there and some, you know, cubic kind of things, curves, angles, puzzle kind of looking things there, and gradients, and just a whole bunch of different designs to each letter, cut it out and stuck it onto what I think might be their aquarium. So that's the assumption I'm going to make. And we see some different fish in there. Very nice aquarium, by the way. Lots of little plants in there. And, so very nice. So thank you, Yoshi, for your submission. And the last submission, as far as the images go, is from the Trash Man, who says, "I love medieval stuff. I have almost no experience in drawing, kind of like me. So I tried something different, tracing. Both the late 14th century knight and English castle are traced, and it was all done in paint, 3D in windows." So very cool. We have a medieval knight with a sword and a scabbard and a halberd or whatever, outside the lines on the castle, inside, outside the lines. We have another scene, nature scene going on, almost like the one here, with the sun and everything. Castle in the background, clouds, and then over here we have a UFO beaming up a cow, which I'm sure is what actually took place back in the medieval times. So nice little different medieval thing. The only medieval thing I think in this little project. So very cool, and thank you, Zed Trash Man, for your contribution. Okay, so that is it for all of the images. We are now going to spend the last few minutes going over the videos, which there are about 8 or 9, and we're going to start with one by Aaron Nelson. So let's take a look at that. It's only about 28 seconds long. We have a turning on a light. There's not going to be, I don't have any volume going on here, but you can see it outside the lines there. Kind of a creative thing going on here with different images and as if a mystery kind of thing. And yeah, very, very different and very cool. It looks like at the very end they put it on the ground and kind of added a burning effect to it, and put a lot of work, it looks like they did, into there. If you take a look at just all the different scenes going on, Root Beer Smensal, Margaret's Garden, Dr. Lampert Shade, a lot of very cool. So I'll put a link to the videos in the description if you want to check them out. So thank you, Aaron, for your work and effort and your submission, of course. Alright, next, moving on to the next YouTube video by Triss. Triss did this. Again, I'm not sure if there's sound, but I took it out just so it's not so loud, louder than me whispering. I think it says good now. And then I move outside the lines. So very cool and creepy, and I love it. The way the animation of the creature, you know, I like that. It's very, very, I love that. That's great. So, awesome job. So thank you, Triss, for your, video there, your work that you put into that. Next up we have by, Just a Dork, who, this is about a minute long, but I can't, sit through the whole thing, but you can see a time lapse here of all the, different characters, or their own, yeah, different characters of the Rift World. Ross, Dave, Professor Clemens, a lot of, I don't mean to zip through There we go, a lot more color. It's already speed lapse, but there is the end. It's already speed art, but I had to speed through it myself just a little bit more. But again, you can check the link in the description. There's Corvus and NWO Band, Charlie Carl, and all that. So, very cool. So, thank you, Justin Dork, for your contribution. Okay, and the next submission we have is by B, a.k.a. KSMR, G-A-Y-S-M-R. So, very cool. Play on words there. And you can check B's channel out. Again, link in the description. This is an 8-minute video, but I had to shrink it down to a minute. So I really, you know, if I only got 20 submissions, I would have been glad to spend more time on everybody's submission. But, you know, I can't. I already said that a few times, I believe. But, yeah, so they, B took outside the lines and drew all this little things, ants on a picnic thing there going. And one of the letters, we can just click back, right? Oh, it's not gonna. There we have a sky, drawing the sky. There we go. Oh, I wanted to. We'll check out that towards the end. Some monsters, some creatures, mushrooms, worms. There's a turkey or something flying there. So, very nice, cool illustration. There we go. Of outside the lines. And if you want to watch the whole video, you'll hear B talk through it. It's an ASMR video. It's about 8 minutes long. You can watch B do all of that on their channel. Very purple hearts and an alien with the peace sign. So very cool. So thank you, B, for your submission. Okay, this next submission is by Connor, who is a flashlight. And looking around the environment, they printed out a bunch of outside the lines stuff. And just want to move the earth through a little bit. They said some of the kids at Arkham Sanitarium were, you know, got out and did all this. That's kind of the role play lore behind this video. And there you can see all different outside the lines. And supposedly this is inside Arkham Sanitarium, I guess. There's Billy who drew that one, and JD up there, and different little, you know, a stop sign, and someone else drawing that one. So very cool. I like it. Very different. So thank you, Connor, for your little unique video take on the whole project. All right, this next one that we saw earlier by Rent for Liv, who colored it in, printed it out, and then put it in the sink. And just ran tap water over it. So that's very cool. That's how I was hoping to get some kind of a different, strange, you know, experimental little short videos like this. And hey, we got one of them, got a few of them, actually. So thank you, Rent for Car Live. I think it was also on Twitch as well. So that's their submission. All right, this next one is by Sammy Lee. This is a GIF. I think Sammy says, I live in Korea and am a student majoring in design. It was fun while I was working on this. I was both nervous and excited, and I hope that in the future you can freely expand the world of art without any burden. I made a GIF of works that contain my emotions. So the whole bunch of stuff going on there. Very cool. We got one little GIF out of all the submissions, which is cool to see, and just a completely experimental and different creations of the outside the lines. Some simple, some painted, some destroyed, a lot of different things going on there. So thank you, Sammy Lee, for your submission. All right, this next one is by Snail. We have outside the lines kind of going on there, and then up. Pops up this little whatever that is, and kind of licks the screen or the viewer or whatever. That's cool. I love it. A lot of nice little effort and work went into that. Definitely, I could watch that over and over. It's cute. It's so cute. It's like a Pokemon or something. But yeah, fuzzy little there. It's got some fire all of a sudden right there in the background as well. So very cool. So thanks for taking your time to do that little illustration and for your submission, Snail. It was great. And then this last video is by Dookie, patient 145327. Just take a look, keep watching, and then there we go. All of a sudden it becomes distorted and into something completely, melts away into something completely unrecognizable, melting into the void, which is what I think they said when they sent that to me. So thank you, Dookie, for your very trippy melting of outside the lines and taking it to somewhere that very unexpected and different, experimental and abstract. And so that's going to do it. So thank you, everyone, for your submissions and all the work that you did. It was great to see all of your different takes and your unique look and your own little vision for what you wanted to do. And almost everything here was different and creative, so it speaks to you, you know, and to all of you, and to just, you know, everyone across the world. How, you know, you give someone an empty blank canvas, and you know, a lot of the times, you know, you might not get the same thing twice. Hopefully that most of you got a chance to watch and see all the different unique takes and you know, of how everyone saw something different and did something different, you know, with the outside the lines. And stay tuned for another community project in about 3 months or so related to photography, but not requiring, you know, expensive camera or anything like that. Some kind of, you know, scavenger hunt or something. We'll figure it out. And until next time, hope to see you in another video or see you somewhere around the halls of the ever-changing Arkham Sanitarium. Take care and so long for now.